Good morning, YouTube, and welcome to day 7, is it, of the Manx Grand Prix? Don't look for a day 6 video. There wasn't one because yesterday was a bit of a washout. They tried to race, it didn't work, so they cancelled everything, so I wasn't out and about. No video from yesterday, but plenty to come today. There's an action-packed day. As you can see, the weather so far is good. There's a warm-up lap. There's a sidecar test lap. There are 3 races. There's a parade lap. Tons of things going on. I've got multiple cameras, 3 different battery packs and all sorts of other things ready for the day. So yeah, it's going to be the usual look at behind the scenes and maybe a bit of racing and all sorts of things. So, you know, I hope you enjoy it. I will try and move positions around a bit. I've got my bike here, so it's the fastest way to go around. So, you know, maybe try and go Governor's Bridge and then try and go Bray Hill or somewhere. I might try some live streaming, might not, depending how battery and everything works, we'll see. I'm also getting more swag to give away, so you know, keep commenting and subscribing, because at the end of Manx Grand Prix, I will pick 10 or 12 winners, depending on how much stuff I buy and get for you, to give away to. So yeah, keep subscribing and commenting. Most creative comments win some swag, so more of that to come. But if you're losing out on this particular swag to free stuff, then there is another amazing chance tomorrow to get your hands on some Manx Grand Prix and TT memorabilia. The mayor of Douglas, as you know, I'm a councillor, so I work with the mayor on her charity committee. Now they have a TT and Manx Grand Prix memorabilia auction tomorrow at Town Hall. You don't have to be here to take part, of course you can. If you are, I will link to it below. But some of the stuff they are auctioning off is absolutely awesome, like priceless signed memorabilia, stuff you can't buy anywhere. So yeah, these are just some of the items coming up for auction tomorrow. You can bid on them by putting a blind bid by a direct message, but you need to do so by lunchtime tomorrow on Sunday. The link to the mayor's Facebook page is below. Send her a message by 12 p.m. tomorrow if you would like to put in a bid, or contact her if you want to attend in person and bid. It's at Douglas Town Hall tomorrow evening. So that's your other chance to get some absolutely awesome memorabilia. Anyway, enough talk. So beautiful day up at the grandstand. We're going to start here and then, yeah, see what the day brings. If the schedule really runs as planned, usually doesn't. I hope everything works well. I hope everything has a safe day. So let's watch some racing. Let's start today with a little bit of a serious message, and that's know your limits. That's the slogan of the road safety initiative of the Isle of Man government. Tell us all about it.
The Isle of Man, of course, has got a long history and a proud history of hosting all sorts of motor events, particularly of course the TT and maybe the lesser well-known MGP. Those events have tended to have quite high casualty rates amongst competitors, sadly, but also amongst visitors to the island. And we've, over the last decade or so, we've really tried to do some work on reducing the number of casualties and fatalities amongst visitors to the island. So and thankfully, touch wood, we have managed to get, over the last 2 years, we've had no fatalities. We've had plenty of casualties, but no fatalities amongst motorcyclists coming to the island to attend the TT or the MGP.
I know, that was an amazing achievement. And I did feature Michael Taylor, Sergeant of the Roads Policing Unit, before. And I know that everyone works pretty hard to achieve that. That's not coincidence, right?
Well, we like to believe that it's not coincidence. We like to believe that it's not because maybe the demographic of people attending the TT is getting a little bit older and a little bit wiser. But I think when you look back at some of the years, and I think it was 1996 from memory, when we had about 11 fatalities amongst visitors to the island during TT and MGP. So that's not competitors, and that's not racers. That's just visitors just going beyond their limits when they're on the mountain road or just racing generally in the Isle of Man. It's well known that the Isle of Man doesn't have a national speed limit, and sometimes people can take advantage of that and do things that perhaps are a little bit beyond their own capabilities. So we're just trying to remind people just to work within their own limits. Obviously not to be using drinking drugs and to be on their motorbikes, because we will catch them, and we've caught a few already. And even though there are certain sections of our roads where we have no speed limits, we do still have rules.
That's what people tend to forget. It's not a free-for-all.
Absolutely. So people tend to think, oh, there's a classic bike coming past. A nice
That's a nice interruption. think we'll leave it at that. There's no way I can talk about it. Yes. Latest addition to the swag pile is, well, a bunch of stuff from the road safety guys, namely the famous Isle of Man shaped bike stands, their earplugs, which are now completely all gone, and some stickers for your helmets or your bike. So I'm going to make them in a set. You get a bike stand, earplugs, and a sticker, and I have about five of those, so five more people who get free stuff from the Isle of Man. Plus, I just got a t-shirt from the Mexican Marine Supporters Club, so we have, yeah, I think we have about 12 things to give away. I think that's about enough, isn't it? I'll see. Maybe we'll find some more. So keep commenting, subscribing to be in with a chance to win some free stuff.
Watching out of the water. I was.
But I didn't know what number it was.
I'm
that. I put a cable tie on so there's not a lot of the car.
Inevitably, we have a schedule change. Totally not predictable that. Nothing ever works to schedule TT or Manx Grand Prix, really. So the parade lap is actually first now. So what you just saw was just a warm-up lap. The parade lap was meant to be later, but they obviously realized that putting a parade lap between races isn't a good idea. So they're now putting it at 1:15. So the next thing I want to show you is the Made at Manx parade lap thing. I will try and actually do two positions for that, because it's a slow lap. One, at St. Ninian's, where they come by, and then I hop on my bike, go down to Governor's Bridge, because they're going to come back down again. So hopefully you get two angles. And then I'm going to go probably back to St. Ninian's for the start of the first race. So, yeah, the inevitable schedule change is already happening, but we're still looking at a full day of racing, hopefully.
Thank you. some money out last year. It's there. It's up on your ticket.
We have numbers 1 to 20 up onto the start line, please. Numbers 1 to 20 onto the start line. Control out. Attention paddock, just a quick update of weather conditions for the competitors for this next race. We have some damp patches. Ones to be aware of is at the exit of Ginger Hall, the exit of White Gates. There are the usual damp patches from Ramsey Hairpin to Waterworks 1, and the usual damp patches from the Nook into the Governor's Dip. And just a reminder, following on from the bulletins that you have all received, if you do have to make a pit stop, it's compulsory to pit at the end of lap one. The people that do not have to pit are single cylinder machines and 350 classics. Control out.
Thank you. Well, that's not what it's worth.
Start of the Manx Grand Prix Supporters Club Junior Race. The race will start in 15 minutes. Can I invite numbers 1 to 20 up onto the start line, please? Control out. Attention paddock for the teams of Daniel Ingham, Jack Fowler, Michael Mace. Please return to the pits as you've left your fuel cans in. They must be taken out of the pits. Control out. minute start line, 3 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you. TT?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah. And some cerveza tonight.
Yeah, but Monday we have another race.
Yeah. Don't worry about that. Tonight party.
Yeah, a little party. Yeah.
A little party?
Yeah.
And looking forward to Monday?
Sorry?
You're looking forward to Monday? Excited?
Yeah. But in the senior, this year in the Manx GP is a very good level, really good level, because other years and the newcomers this year are so fast.
Yeah.
So we'll see. We'll see what happens. I will push. So see what happens.
Gracias. Everybody, give it up for your podium. Maurizio Batalico. Andrea Mayola and Victor Lopez. Woo. Gracias.
Well done.
Thank you very much.
Give them a round of applause, everybody.
It's too late.
Come on, John. You're slacking.
What's happening now, Justin?
We are going to prepare ourselves for the Shiro Lightweight Manx Grand Prix, which is over three laps, and that's at 6:15.
Come on! Half past six.
So about 20 minutes. And a little bit of background music before that. And then that's pretty much it for the evening. 80s DJ on tonight over there at the bar. So some nice smashing the machines.
Hemos gozado de lo lindo, hemos estado.
No, tú, Pablo, ven.
Visto, que eres campeón.
¡Ay, joder!
¡Eres un campeón! ¡Me cago en la leche!
¡He peleado que te encanta!
¡Ay, joder! ¡Miti! ¡Va con los chiquillos!
¡Venga, que me está llamando! ¡Ahora!
¡Empieza la carrera! ¡Empieza la carrera!
Thank you.
What's that? Did they get there?
I think I had a first round
So that's pretty much the end of today. Now what you see happening here right now is very unusual. Convoy of bikes coming in because they shortened the last race. They don't have those open cars already out. They're bringing all the bikes back with Marshall. Never seen that before, to be honest, that they bring them back like that. So yeah, they just brought all the riders back under Marshall's guidance because the race was shortened because the weather, as you can see there, cloudy on the mountain. So that's pretty much it for today. Man, that was a long day. So turns out Mike Brown not only won the race but also has the same birthday as me, and it's also my wedding anniversary today. So there you go, what a perfect day. Everyone came back safe. Awesome racing, awesome weather, awesome people. I hope you enjoyed this little glimpse at Manx Grand Prix 2023 day, what is it, 7? I don't know. Tomorrow there's no racing, but I'll be out and about for the, there's a Spitfire display, there's the show and shine on the prom, there's the parade lap of course in the morning. I may try and go out to Derby, I don't know yet. My car needs a new battery, so let's see if I make it out there. So no racing tomorrow, but plenty of other things to come. I'll show you all of that tomorrow. And then we're back on Monday for the final day of racing. So I hope you enjoyed this short look. Short? It's a long day, this. Short look at Manx Grand Prix 2023, day 7. Saturday. Now I'm going to head home, edit this, upload it. Have some food, have a drink, and collapse. See you tomorrow.